All right, well, Frank, obviously a phenomenal fight, man. Very entertaining. Talk about how it felt kind of being in there.
First off, you know, I like to take my hats off, man, to Damian Brown and him and his camp. You know, I was struggling real bad the morning of, you know, trying to make weight, and I was unprofessional, and I had to at least give him a chance of fighting in front of his home country. You know what I mean? We were struggling in the morning, and I just want to thank him for giving me the opportunity and that we get to showcase our skills together. You know, and man, it was fun. It was fun. I was having a blast, and so, you know, maybe, and my coaches are in the back. I was maybe having a little too much fun, but it was man, it's what I do. So I love to do.
Both of you guys had the same nutritionist going into this fight, it turns out. George Lockhart worked both with Damian and yourself.
Yeah.
What exactly went wrong? Was it weird having the same guy, I suppose, working with both fighters going into this fight?
You know, I had no idea, and it was nothing on George. What happened was I cut the water a little too early. That's what happened. So the day before, right when I was going to start cutting, my body was actually holding it, you know? So I messed up on my part, and man, George got me a six pack. You know what I mean? So, man, good man. I just messed up on my part.
Is there a bit of confusion, because it seems like a lot of fighters when they come here in Australia, you know, the fights are on a Sunday,
yeah,
as opposed to how in the States normally it's on a Saturday. Is that sort of a bit of an adjustment period for when you come down here?
Not an adjustment. The only weird thing is after the fight we're gonna have lunch. You know, usually it's like after the fight we're gonna go get a midnight snack. You know what I mean? Or even coming to the venue, everything was, hey, good morning, good morning, good morning. You know, so that was very different. But as far as training and acclimatizing or whatever you want to use it, we're in the same time zone, so it's just getting my morning training in, you know.
When you go to the judge's decision, obviously they start reading it out. How were you feeling at the time? Did you think you had done enough, and how did you feel as it was being read out?
I felt like I did enough, and I felt like I gave it my all. What I didn't do with the Leech fight, and that I felt that I did different, I don't know if it makes a difference or not, but man, I just felt confident, you know. And the fight with Leech, I was kind of just embracing it after the fight, you know. I just kind of like went to my corner, man, this one I knew I won, and I knew I did this. I got in the cage and I was just embracing the Australian crowd, you know. And man, the people, the fans here, just, they can appreciate a good fight, and that was super dope.
I think you're the leader in the clubhouse right now for $50,000, perhaps. Well, see if the weight thing factors in there. Did they talk to you about that at all?
You know, I haven't talked to them about it. Man, I would, dude. I mean, we put it out there. The 50K fight of the night, you know, would be awesome. But man, if it doesn't happen for me, man, at least give Damian Brown his award, you know, because you know, he came, he showed up, and I hope that at least if I don't qualify, man, get the guy his you know, his son has a, you know, his first birthday coming up, dude. So.
That's a nice sentiment there. So you'd be okay with getting the award, but no money.
Man, but I mean, shoot, I would love the money, you know? Man, please. I mean, you know, that's what we do, man. I went out there, I left it all out, and man, I was biting down on my mouthpiece, and we were throwing it and giving the fans what they love, you know? And, you know, we'll see. But the guy did his part. I did my part somewhat, and... But yeah, I would love for him to at least get some of that, you know. Me, I mean, if you guys want, you know, you guys can. I'll come back clean, and I'll come back like a pro next fight. Most definitely.
They could just give you some camera gear.
I already got my camera gear, so I don't need it. Maybe a task cam. I could take that one right there. No, but yeah, for sure.
Dan, you're the first ever fighter who's come out here and started touching our gear and actually knew exactly what we were using. You were, as you described it, nerding out a little bit. where does this knowledge come from about cameras and lenses and stuff?
I'm a huge, I find media and I find multimedia very fascinating, you know, and I can appreciate good camera gear, and I can mostly especially appreciate a good story. And, you know, as a fighter, you know, going into mixed martial arts, you know, at this starting level, there's no real money to kind of like to support the dream, you know what I mean? So, you know, I need to create a media, I need to create something, and I feel like I have a story to tell, and I feel like every fighter has a story to tell. So if you have a solid team behind you, a solid PR team, and just kind of get your story out there, and now you can find sponsors or people that resonate with your story and support that dream, and you know, be attached to your brand as you climb, you know. And you know, we win together, we lose together, but man, we're a team. And anyway, I just find all of that so fascinating, and then ending up nerding out, and then after my last fight, I finally checked out of my Amazon cart, you know, that I've been having, you know, all these things on Amazon. Okay, man, I want a Sony A7S2. Oh man, I need this digital recorder. Whoa, okay, I'm gonna order a 64 gigabyte card, you know, all this stuff. So anyway, we can go on and on and on about this. I love it, absolutely love it, and I really appreciate what you guys do, man, because this is what helps us get to where we need to be, you know.
Just quickly, just getting back to fighting, Dan Hardy suggested that there should be a rematch between you and Damian Brown, with you making the weight. Would you be open to that, possibly in Perth in February?
Dude, let's do it. Yeah, Damian Brown, man, you know, and I feel like I owe that to him, you know. And if that's what the fans want to see, I mean, I wouldn't mind coming back to Australia, you know. Man, let's do it, Damian Brown. You know, I'll come in as a pro, and yeah, let's. Yeah, dude, David, let's do it, man. Let's do it, dude. We're gonna do it.